Safety. Our society requires safety, but the question for today is why there are four people for safety on the four corners. You see these guys that say slow, and there's another one say stop, and another one over there, all the way over there, all the way over there saying stop or slow, and hey, over there, there's one more with the orange jacket, and there's only two workers working. Yes, there's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 stop signs, four stop signs, three working, and one police officer over there. And because our requirement for the safety of the human life in the United States of America, that's what usually happens. The safety is regarded as a high level safety, but the work, you know, there's like, you see these guys over there struggling, they don't even have machines somehow, a manual labor, it's conducted here, you see the guys pushing the pipes, somehow, that's how this nation is operating. It's more safety, which is of course, more safety, yes, over there, you know, like, I'm supposing that, yes, that this project will take forever, and of course, the city of New York is very, very efficient on the safety. Four workers sitting on the corner. You know why? Because the presupposition, the assumption that people are dumb, you know, like, actually, this guy, well, while I was trying to cross, you know, the guy actually was stopping me and stopping the car, because somehow this government or whatever it is, you know, this institution does not trust the people that they are conscious being. They are like, in the eyes of these guys, we are stupid pawns and idiots who does not know how to cross the street. The cars does not know how to cross. There are lights here, but safety first. You've heard that. You've heard that, right? Safety first, and it's always safety first. And safety, it's a very important thing. But when safety becomes more than the work done, you know, I don't expect this finish project to be finished soon, because as far as I can see, three people over there in the far away in the, oh yeah, oh, there's like four people now. I guess one of the guy that is looking at the workers, yes, one of the guy, I guess, suppose he's a manager. We need also management. We gotta manage. One guy sitting in there walking around with his hands in his pocket is a manager to manage three people and four people safety and one police officers, because somehow we are all stupid people. We don't know how to cross the street. We do not know. So this is how safety comes first. And of course, this has to do a lot with our operation of the system. Operation of the system is like this. It's an operation of the system is saying this, the law, because God forbid somebody got hurt here, you know, by the law they may sue this organization, and whoever is the organization, right, doing the job, they may be sued. So the law say, God forbid if a pedestrian is being hurt into this thing, so this organization, this company that is doing this thing, it has to put massive human resources on the safety, because, you know, if somebody got hurt, that would be millions of dollars. And that's how it works, this project, because just to say that, it's very simple. You know, America has turned out to be a giant system for extracting money from each other, you know. And like, for example, if you slip in McDonald's, you know, you can sue McDonald's because they didn't have this sign. And this has nothing to do with the employees, but has to do with the signs that have to say wet floor. If some employee did not put the signs, you know. So we are assuming that people are idiots, and Yes, they do not see the floor is wet. They just don't see, you know. But of course, if somebody falls in an establishment or in a business, the government is here to protect them, you know. And when he goes to the hospital, let's say he broke his leg or something, there will be a lawyer in the hospital. The lawyer will find him and will tell him, hey, you know what, you can get $250,000, $205,000, $3 million, whatever. We're gonna sue this corporation for $5 million. Best we can, we guarantee you like $1 million or $100,000. Would you like to sign this paper? And of course, the hurt guy who is a presumptuously an idiot, you know, say yes, that's a good way to make money. So many people now in America do that. Actually, I do have a guy, a friend of mine. His main concern is to go around Midtown Manhattan and to sue corporations because somehow their employees told him something that is wrong. So this guy, that's how this guy makes a living, yeah? Suing, it's a big business. And, you know, recently I have been watching about some stuff about the healthcare system and how people, hospitals and stuff. And today, interesting number. They say the planet Earth has a 7.3 trillion dollars in the food industry. The food industry, watch this number, 7.3 trillion dollars to feed this planet. And somehow the pharmaceutical industry, the big pharma, or anything that to do with the health and the well-being of the people, it is a 7.4 trillion dollars industry. So, which business are we in? In the business of feeding people or the business of getting people sick? And later on, of course, cure them. We gotta cure these sick people. How many things we can give them? You know, we are assuming people are stupid, and to some extent they are stupid. You know, we know we are slightly stupid. We smoke cigarettes, we use drugs, we use alcohol. You know, like the searching mind has no rest. The searching mind, the mind that is asking these solutions, you know, most of the American people will find solace in the nearest bar. Hey, there you go, one nearest bar. Here in our area, in the Hell's Kitchen, somehow most of these establishments that used to be a coffee shop or a hardware store or whatever, they turn out to be a bar establishment, you know. Hello, hey, is there a bar around? A bar, I want to go get some drink, like whiskey.
Probably.
Where is the bar?
I don't know. I check on like this avenue or on that avenue.
Okay.
I don't know where it is.
Thank you. I'll find one. Yes, I'm going for a whiskey. And guess what? There will be a bar here. Yes, you know, like in these big corporations, you know, like these big corporations that own the rental properties, they are full with rental slaves inside, and somehow they you know, inside the place, you know, like this one for example, Avalon, it's a big thing, you know. And guess what, you will not see a coffee shop or anything to do with health or maybe yogi salon or some gym. Yes, there is gym somewhere in the side, but in the front there is a Ardesia, which is a guy here helpfully cleaning, you know, like one of these guys cleaning. And let's see, what is it inside? Well, it's a A-grade. It's a drink up, as you can see. Oh, drink it up, my buddy. And this here, happy people, testimonials from New York Times and all these good stuff. But yeah, on the other side, the smart corporation has like something like a restaurant, but don't worry, that is not a restaurant. That is more like a bar, you know, and that's how it goes. Very efficient, yes, everything is very efficient. First, we're gonna get the people sick, we're gonna stuck them with drugs, with alcohol, we're gonna legalize everything. By the way, you know, recently people have been talking about legalizing marijuana. I would say you know, why not legalize cocaine as well? Cigarettes are legal, alcohol is legal, all the air pollution, it's actually legal, and spitting on the street is legal. Who the hell would stop the free mind to use some cocaine, you know? That's right. Cocaine should be legal, because I don't see, in reality, I don't see too much difference between weed and cigarettes and cocaine and wine and whiskey and all these goodies, you know. They are good, right? They are good to a certain extent. A glass of wine at the end of the day might not be a bad idea, or let's say 2 glasses of wine per week might not be a good, or might not be a very bad idea. But smoking cigarettes every day, like myself or some of my friends, most of the American friends, and of course some immigrants, they like say, I don't smoke cigarettes, I just smoke weed. And the problem is when it becomes a habit on a daily basis, slows you down. But anyway, we're not going to talk about this. We're going to talk about the big efficiency here. A lot of workers, busy bees, are busy doing work. And now I'm going to be a busy bee and to do some work. And here is one more good corporation, the fastest growing corporation on the planet Earth. It's called Subway. Subway, eat fresh. Yes, eat fresh, but the question is, eat what? Eat fresh, but eat what? So that's for the day. I hope you hear this rant, slightly negative, you know, slightly negative. If you have if you at the end of this video, you will notice that this is a slightly negative negative coverage. but there's nothing bad in the negatives. They are just for our attention, for us to know they do exist. Because otherwise, if you do not know the negative stuff, if you do not know the danger, well, we might be the victims of the cigarettes, of the marijuana, of the drugs, of the very big safety precautions of the government. We might be a victim of that. And the main idea here is that people somehow lost their human ability to be sensible about this stuff. You know, they just don't care. I came from I ran away from the communism, and one of the big issues of the communism was that it was not the party. You know, it was the party. It was like one of these internet gurus say, you know, like a very older guy. Maybe Noam Chomsky. Maybe that was Noam Chomsky that say, what's the difference between capitalism and communism? There's not much, you know. In the communism, it was a one corporation. And in the capitalism, is one corporation on the top called the government. And 100 more underneath that rule the whole country and perhaps the world. This, the 100 corporations. And then underneath becomes The 500. Now there is a new list in business. If you are in business, you should know that there is a new list. It's called the 5000 Inc. 5000 Inc. It's like 5000 corporations now. But you see the structure. The structure is, it's kind of top to down structure. So it doesn't really matter if it's going to be one corporation in the communism or 100 corporations in the capitalism. Is the same shit. You know, it's like just it's just pretty much the same. And in this regard, I would now mention the worst in the communism, like that these people in the communism, they was very cleverly designing the structure so everyone should believe in the party, in the bright future, you know. Like here in America, it's something called the American dream. You gotta be optimistic, you gotta chase it, it will happen to you. But the mechanism here is a competition. There, was in the communism, the communist idea, they didn't like the competition. They like a dumb people, you know, just obedience. So the worst problem in the communism was that if somebody did not believe in the ideas of the Communist Party, they was expelled, and they was called something like a dissident or a traitor or a foe or many other words, you know, conspirators, right? They was these conspirators back in the communism that run away. Some of them run in the 80s and the 70s and even in the 60s. They run away from the communist society, culture and structure, and they went to the capitalism, but soon they understand. They did not upgrade, yes? They did not upgrade. Somehow they may upgrade some, you know, freedom, but not too much freedom. If you look around the matrix, you will see that there's not too much of a difference. And when you go historically, like starting with the structures that we know, such as the Roman Empire, you will see that the United States of America totally duplicate this ruling power. There's three bodies of power, and one, of course, it's called the law. But that is not the law. For some of my viewers, if they do not know, in America the best law that works here, it's called the UCC law. Most of the people do not know, and they go like this libertarians and these fighters for First Amendment, you know, they do not know that in reality there is one law called UCC, Uniform Commercial Codes, and that's all we are victim of, you know. Like, for example, I gave you in the beginning of the video, I showed you this very efficient structure, like four people for security and three people working and one manager on the top. That is the idea. But why? Because we are governed by the UCC law, and anyone can sue anyone without looking them as human beings, you know, like, we have this excuse, you know, the excuses. It's the corporation, and we don't look at the real life, you know, we don't say hello anymore to people, even they pretend that they are very polite, and they say hello, but I mean, if they don't want to take your money, they most likely neglect you, don't even look at your face. Yeah, this is like my rant for the day. I hope you like it. It's a bit negative, but we're gonna keep it positive for the next time. And subscribe to the channel.